Hello everyone and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to my UMass Minutemen Dynasty here in NCAA 13. UMass is fresh off a comeback win against Northern Illinois, taking them out 21-17. It's time to do some recruiting there right after that game. Now I've taken some advice of the people in the comments, and I've gone and added some people to the board who are at the top 8 stage of choosing a school. So with this change, with this addition, brings a refocused look at our recruiting. We've got some guys here that are actually some pretty decent overall that maybe we can get on their boards. Maybe some of them we don't, but we take a shot at some of them because we've got the chance to go ahead and scout some of these guys out and see just how things turn out. You see an athlete here, Markeith Calhoun, that we're taking a look at. And he starts at an 85 overall, but of course as an athlete, it'll take forever to unlock all of those attributes. He's already dropped down to an 81, which might be good for us because then maybe he falls more from the big schools. Bo Nelson here from Apple Valley, Minnesota. I gotta love that. That caught my eye. He's a JUCO D tackle. Got Justin Towson, the number one overall quarterback. We're taking a run at him? Sure, why not? So I'm learning from past failures, and I'm not going out there and offering these guys big things like scholarships before they're on my board. Learned that in live streams from people helping me out to just ease them in until I'm on the board, and then you go after the big points. So that's what we're going to do. Just looking at an overview of who we may be looking at in future episodes. We'll detail more as we go after those specific players, but for now, it is time to take on Ohio. This should be a pretty good MAC game right here. We got to look out for Darius Vick at the quarterback position. You see he's thrown for 871 yards already. So we'll have to try to shut him and the Ohio offense down. And hopefully we can use the home crowd here to get the defense going and keep them in line. So as UMass hits the field here, they're going to play in white helmets today. Yeah, and white pants. So it's just changing up the uniform set a little bit here from game to game. I don't have all that many options with UMass, but I try to keep it fresh. So we go to the field now, second and 11, and Collins is going to hit Ronnie Parker there, just short of a first down. That's Ronnie Parker's first catch of the day, as you see him get open here and settle down just before the sticks. So it'll be third and one, and Jim Mitchell's going to get that first down for us, as we expect him to do so. So on first and 10, hand off to Mitchell again to the left, and he gets some blocking, and he's going to be running inside the 40 to the 35-yard line. Great start for Jim Mitchell, getting that speed going to the outside, and you see the replay here. Great block by the fullback out front, springs him for even more yardage. Great play there, first and 10 now. Looking to go play action. Look out, Wes Collins, no blocking in the backside, and the blitz gets him before he even knows what's going on. So that's a loss right there. And the play action is no good. So third and 16, they're going to go four verts. And look over the middle of the field for Quayshon Smith, who makes the catch and is going to drag the defender inside the 5-yard line. First and goal, UMass. It's a big, no, a huge third and long play to convert here and get the first and goal to keep the offense on the field and try to get the first points of the ball game. So on first and goal, send Howard in motion to the right. And hand off to Jim Mitchell, a little right. Gonna cut inside because that's where the hole is for the easy touchdown. 6 points for the Minutemen. And they're on the board first. You see the replay. Jim Mitchell has no problem there. Routing right up the middle and getting the touchdown. So UMass on the board first. And the defense is out now to try to make a stop. Hammonds is got other plans. He's gonna run to the right-hand side for a first down. And Ohio shows some promise right from the start here. We've got a little bit of game freezing, but that's not going to stop Ryan McBride from winning this wrestling match and getting the player down to the ground to force fourth down. Nice play right there. So Wes Collins out of the shotgun. Third and 17, hole they got him into. But look at this catch. Ronnie Parker. Oh my goodness, what a great catch. Looked like he was kind of going into a stumble, maybe trying to keep his footing. But he hauls this in kind of like an over-the-shoulder basket catch, and he keeps it from hitting the ground, all while staying with a foot in bounds. So here's a deep ball to Ronnie Houston. He was open, But Collins overshoots him to the sideline. It's going to be 4th and 19. They got a punt. So they waste the Ronnie Parker catch. 3rd and 11 now for Vic, who should have been picked off there, frankly. Linebacker knocks it down. It'll be 4th down, so it forces a punt there as well. Well into the second quarter now when Jim Mitchell will take this hand off to the left-hand side. He's got some speed, and he's got 9.5 yards before he's taken down. 3rd and 8 later in the drive. Wes Collins finds a wide-open Dobbs, who makes a nice move before getting helicoptered to the ground. But the next play is not a good one right there. Picked off. Wes Collins, well, he forced the ball. That's pretty much the story right there. So it's a turnover, and we got to play defense once again right before half. Vic is going to find his man for a first down. So maybe that turnover is a costly thing here. We got to play some defense and not let him get on the board. But another first down, and all of a sudden we've given Ohio momentum. That's not what we want to see. Right before half, Vic is going to throw again here. Another good 8 or 9 yards. So 2nd and 1, what do they call? Another pass play. Vic waiting, throwing. Oh, what a play. Ryan McBride stretches out, makes the interception, and stays in bounds. What a turnover there by UMass's defense. I believe this kid's just a freshman. Look at that catch. And has the poise to secure it, stay in bounds. And that is how your first half's going to end. A 7-0 UMass lead at the break. So far, the defense has done more than we could ask for. Vic's going to throw to the left here to Taylor, who's going to be hit down, but not until he gets 5 yards. 2nd and 5 now. Vic to throw again. And he's going to loft it in there. Nice play. Atwell makes a nice catch despite getting just blasted. But he hangs on for the catch. 2nd and 10. Atwell again. Some shoddy tackling there. And he probably would have had a first down anyway. But gets a few more yards because of it. So now 2nd and 3. Still out of that like pistol formation that we see often here in the MAC conference. That's going to be caught. But it's 3rd and inches now. And Vic's going to throw to Roberts, who, well, let's look at the spot. Yep, they give it to him. Not by much. First down. So here comes Ohio. They get another first down right there. Things moving smoothly for them now. But they got 3rd and 6 here. And they got to make a play to the end zone. Oh, he had his hands on it, but it is knocked down. The defense does just enough to make sure that's an incomplete pass. On comes the field goal unit for 4th and 6. And the kick is good to cut the lead to 7-3 here midway through the third quarter. Back to UMass's offense with Jim Mitchell. Going to try to work to the left and get 7 yards. He's got 55 for the game now. And on a 2nd and 9 play, Collins looking to throw. Gets some heat in his face right there, but he does get the ball off to Ronnie Houston, who gets a big first down. So on 1st and 10, hand off to Jim Mitchell. Here he goes to the outside. Oh my goodness, he put the ball on the turf again. And it's recovered by Ohio. Oh, that's not what Junk Johnson was looking for out of his offense right there. Jim Mitchell's a stud, but he is prone to doing this once in a while, putting the ball on the carpet. It seems like we see this, too often, really. We got to cut down on that. So 2nd and 6 now for Vic and the Ohio Bobcats. That one's knocked down. Could have been picked off, but that's a middle linebacker, so I'll give him a pass with short arm that ball. So 3rd and 6 now. Vic is going to find his man for first down at midfield. Okay, third quarter is winding down, and Ohio's thinking about driving here. They're going to go with the option play. Pitches out to Hammonds, and he's got nowhere to go except backwards. He's thumped there, and it's going to be 3rd and long. So what they want to do is make sure they don't give up the long play here and a conversion. They give him underneath, and it's a good 4 yards short, but they're going to go on 4th and 4. It's a little early still in the fourth quarter to be gambling, but they get it. They get the conversion and keep their offense on the field. Oh, you see Smith not happy right there that they allowed that first down. But here he's going deep one-on-one, and Smith gets the revenge. He wasn't happy about the last first down. Well, he does something about it. He gets the interception for UMass, and now this is a big opportunity for Jim Mitchell to get back out on the field, show he can hang on to the football and maybe close this game out. But they got to get out of the shadow of their own goal line here. Fullback Coleman leading the block there. He gets five. So second and five. Call Mitchell again. And he's going to spin around, hang onto that ball. He's going to be 2 yards short. So on third and two, fullback leading again. Gets a pretty good block. Mitchell shifts to the left there and finds room for a first down. The Bobcat not happy. But the home crowd is. So Mitchell out to the left, and he's got another first down. And they're going to say, wind that clock. He's still in bounds. He did a good job of not going out. So second and four, and another first down. One timeout left for Ohio. They need to force a fumble or something here. Second and five. At the very least, make a stop. Okay, only 1 yard there. Third and four. And we are at the minute and a half mark. This is a big play. Mitchell rips it off. First down. UMass is going to win this ball game. Oh, boy. Hasn't been pretty all day. As a matter of fact, the only score was on the first drive. But we are at the minute mark. And if Mitchell hangs onto the ball, which he will here after putting a little spin on UMass, can call this a victory. There you go. Victory formation. They don't even need to snap it. UMass wins a close one. This was a tough battle. You know, Ohio's defense was pretty quick to the ball. They had to really work for everything they got. UMass's defense stood tall and is pretty much the story of this game, holding Ohio to only 3 points. So it's another victory on the season, and we're 5-1 now. Not too bad. We're finally representing in MAC play. Jim Mitchell, your player of the game, 23 carries for 138 yards and the lone touchdown of the game. Let's look at the stats here. Wes Collins, he's had better days and he will have better days. 7 for 14 for 138 and that pick. Jim Mitchell, that's why he's your player of the game right there. Toughs out 138 yards and is the story of this ball game. We look at the receiving core and what do we have? Ronnie Parker, the only one with multiple catches on the day. Not a whole lot going on offensively, except for the ground game. But a win is a win, and they will take it. Moving forward, as we look forward to the next week, it'll be Miami of Ohio. After we do some recruiting, we will see you for the next episode of UMass Dynasty.